And let me introduce you to our first guest on this Friday morning. Rhone Resch is the president and CEO of the Solar Energy Industries Association, representing their interests here in Washington, D.C. Mr. Resch, thanks so much for being with us.
Susan, thank you for having me.
Today, executives from Solyndra are expected to come to Capitol Hill. We're told they're going to plead Fifth Amendment and not testify before Congress. I wonder your reaction to this headline in Politico earlier this month, Solyndra scandal, a PR nightmare for the solar industry. Sorry, do you feel that you're in the middle of a quagmire here?
Well, I think there's no doubt that what's happened is it's become a political issue rather than the public really taking an accurate look at what's going on in the solar industry. And I think it's a mistake if we start to judge the entire industry based on the performance of one company. I mean, we are operating in an extremely competitive market. We are going to have companies that succeed and companies that fail. But the reality is the fact that the solar industry grew by over 70% this last quarter from last year, and we're one of the fastest growing industries in the United States today. That story needs to get out there, Susan.
Well, we're inviting you to do that. I'm going to tell our audience that we thought it would be useful to get a primer on the overall solar industry, and we welcome your questions or comments for Mr. Resch as we do that. Well, let me ask you, just rather than using the expression fastest growing, how big an industry is it in the United States? How many people does it employ?
Today we employ over 100,000 people. That's twice as many as we employed just 2 years ago. There's 5,000 companies in the United States, and that makes up manufacturers and construction and installers, and they're operating in all 50 states today. And so what we've seen as this industry has grown is that it's put a lot of Americans back to work. Electricians, roofers, plumbers, those who've been let go by the housing industry have found a new opportunity in solar.
And what is the global competition like?
Well, the reality is right now the United States is not in first place. Germany installs about 8 times as much solar as we do each year in the United States. In fact, Japan is ahead of us, Italy is ahead of us. So right now on an installation side, we're actually in fourth place. We're not on the medal stand. However, we're growing fast, and we think that the U.S. will be the largest market in the world by 2014.
What's the basic elements needed for a successful solar business? What's involved in the technology?
So there's multiple technologies. First, there's photovoltaics, which are panels that directly convert sunlight to electricity. There's solar water heating, which are panels that heat up water for cooking, cleaning, showering, or industrial purposes. And then there's concentrating solar, which focuses the sunlight and creates very high temperatures that generate steam and basically generate electricity. So each one of those has a very different business model. But typically for the homeowner or a small installer, what they're doing is installing solar electric and solar thermal systems on homes that directly displace electricity, allowing customers to lower their electricity bills and provide a clean energy source for their homes.
So there's residential, there's commercial, and there's also agricultural solar, is that correct?
There's agricultural, and then there's utility scale, so solar power plants in the desert southwest taking advantage of the world-class solar resources that we have.
And which segments of the business are the largest right now?
It's a good question. Well, all of them are growing, which is great news. The largest segment is the commercial. So these are rooftop installations or ground-mounted installations that you'd see on a Home Depot, a Lowe's, Walmart, Walgreens, those kinds of buildings. We've seen that sector grow a little over 30% quarter on quarter. And in fact, where people typically think about solar being only a California technology, New Jersey is now the number one state for installing commercial operations this second quarter here in the United States. So an exciting development as you're seeing more markets open up really around the country.
So would you explain to the public the ways in which the federal government, probably primarily through the U.S. Department of Energy, helps support and foster solar technology?
You know, it's interesting. The federal government has made it a priority to support all energy technologies for the last 100 years. The oil and gas industry has enjoyed incentives, permanent incentives, since 1916, coal industry since the 30s, the nuclear industry since the 50s. It really wasn't until the 2005 energy bill that any real incentive was provided to help homeowners and businesses go solar. The great news is, though, that since that policy has been put in place, we've seen the industry grow by over 600%. And so we are now competing on a cost basis with natural gas in California. So we're seeing these investments pay off very quickly as not only we scale up the industry, but as costs come down to the consumer.
You call them investments. Are these in the form of grants or loans or both?
So we have the loan guarantee program, which was created in the 2005 energy bill as well, and then expanded and adopted in the Recovery Act in 2009. That program is designed to invest in those technologies or those projects that are considered higher risk or, frankly, innovative, such that they can't attract the capital from Wall Street to finance either the scale or the new technology. But ultimately, the advancement, the policies that are really advancing the solar industry are in the form of tax credits, investment tax credits, similar to what are enjoyed by most of the other energy technologies.
We have some examples from a longer list of federal loan guarantees, and here's a look at them. One of them is the one we just showed you in the news, First Solar, $4.4 billion, Bright Source Energy of California, $1.6 billion. Abengoa, is that correct?
Abengoa,
solar in Arizona, 1.4, and Solyndra, the one that's in the news right now, is $535 million. What changed? You said the program changed during the stimulus program. How did the loan guarantee program change with that program?
They expanded it such that it focused more on deployment, actual projects that were going to be put in the ground, and that companies could come and apply multiple times. So instead of it being a one-off example, the program really adjusted to be able to advance the technology much farther, much faster.
With the hope of creating more jobs quickly, is that right?
Absolutely. And that's what it's done. When you look at those, and that's what it's done. When you look at those 10 projects that have been approved, you know, the vast majority of them were just in August and September of this year. 7 out of 10 projects just received funding. But those that have been in place for a while, including the Abengoa project that you mentioned, are creating jobs in some in rural areas in this country that have some of the highest unemployment across the entire country. So they're really making investments and moving dirt and creating new opportunities in those communities.